When I was young, I used to love mirrors. The instant response, the smiling face looking back at me at my happiest moments, and crying alongside me at my darkest days. The reflection understood me like none other, accepted and responded to my every move. Now, as I stand between two of these surreal, reflective surfaces, I find myself looking upon infinite worlds of possibilities. If I dare to look close enough, I can seize a glimpse of what the present might hold if only my dreams turned into reality. I touch one of the surfaces, amazed by its lack of imperfections, and I sink into the silvery mass of liquid as small waves engulf me in a sea of silver. I let myself be shrouded into a million pluralities, all different from me, and yet the same in all aspects that matter. I reach out to one reality and stand in awe as it comes into focus. It looks and feels so very real. I see myself happy. How long has it been since I've been so happy and so, oh, so full of life? I'm swimming in a pool in front of a huge mansion which is unmistakably mine, as the coat of arms in the front door dictates. The reflection in the watery mass grabs my attention. I jump and succumb to the vortex of infinite realities once more. I'm in an office, so many floors above the ground. The view is mesmerizing, and the city looks modern. There's scarcely any furniture, but the little there is gives a formidable elegance to the oversized room. Admiring the view through the roof-to-floor glass windows is yet another version of me. The immense trademark on the back wall reveals the name of the company I own, and the slogan, "United We Stand." I touch its metallic surface, and the world blurs out yet again into a whirlpool of possibilities. I'm in the yard of a small, comfy house. A pure white husky barking playfully, and a large front lawn. A beautiful, familiar girl walks towards me with two lemonades and kisses me softly and passionately before handing me one of the shiny glasses. "How was your day?" she asks. I look at the sweet liquid, and my reflection looks right back at me. I blink once. I'm back. Back between a duality of mirrors. I now realize all those futures, presents, and pasts could have been mine if only I hadn't spent all my life in front of these mirrors. Now I'm old. Much too old to start again. I'm beyond what any mirror can fix, no matter how mystical. And soon enough, the figure in the mirror will be gone forever. A small tear slides down my face. The silver surface lays untethered and broken at my feet. And I feel free. Free of self-consciousness and self-limitation. Purely and utterly free from the labyrinth of mirrors.